singles out there, for those who used to be single, and so forth. When it comes to dating, we can all agree that everybody has their different views and different opinions on how to move about and how to go forth in that environment. For instance, some people, you know, are serial daters. They date, you know, a lot of people at one time. Some people are, you know, monogamous. They just have interest in one person. They put all their interests and their attention and direction into that one person. Some people just date for, you know, to find a life partner and not just to have fun or entertainment. But, you know, to each his own. At the end of the day, everybody has their own way of moving. Like, you can't tell what somebody, what's right or wrong for them. Whatever they feel like is okay for them, that's them. You know, we can't judge or try to persuade them to adapt to the way that we are. We can only find what complements, you know, our own view. So even though we have these different views and different ways to go about within the dating realm, there's always one thing that remains pretty constant, and that's preferences. Everybody has preferences. Everybody has certain things that they look for, certain things that they won't accept and can't accept, and so forth. So I was having a really good conversation with one of my buddies earlier today about this, and he was kind of putting his, you know, things on the line of what he would not take within a girl, and I was giving mine and so forth. We kind of comparing, and what I found is that there's actually different types of preferences. Like, there's preferences that you can kind of overlook and still, you know, just if you're vibing with somebody, you can, if you're vibing with someone, you can overlook them. But there's some preferences that no matter what, you have to hit those things. You know, you have to hit that standard, so to speak. So I'll give you like an example. So if my preference is chocolate ice cream, right? And I see a girl that's eating vanilla ice cream, and I go, "Why are you eating vanilla ice cream?" She goes, "Well, I like vanilla ice cream." I go, "You don't like chocolate?" And she's like, "No, I don't like chocolate." Like, that type of preference, like, it's easy to overlook because it's really not that important. Like, it's such a trivial thing, you know what I'm saying? That's not going to affect, you know, our relationship or our ambitions, you know, towards the future with having a family or whatever, you know, anything like that. So that's one side of a preference. That's something that's real small, something that each person can say, "Oh, I can overlook that. That's pretty small. I like this person a lot. You know, she's cool, I'm cool, whatever. We can vibe, we can figure this thing out." See, then there's like the other side. I was talking with my boy about this, like the other, like, deeper side of preferences, and that's like, we call them the red flags or whatever. So you have, like, you know, the religion, and you have politics, and you have, you know, all these other different types of, you know, social things that go on, and like, you have to weigh and measure those against each other. So it's like, if your ambition is to, like, maybe you have kids one day and she doesn't want to have kids, or you don't want to have, like, say somebody, one of you guys doesn't have that ambition to have kids, it's probably not going to work because the preference is so disconnected, you know, towards that future ambition. You know, it's not going to probably play out the way you want it to. So you can try to overlook it, but at the end of the day, that thing is always going to come back. It's always going to be like, you know what? I really wanted this. I can't really overlook it. So our relationship is probably not going to move, you know, efficiently. You know, to kind of go deeper, you know, I'll talk from a personal side, you know, like with, you know, like with religion, you know, I am a Christian. And in our faith, it talks about being unequally yoked. And that basically refers to dating outside of the faith or getting into a relationship or marriage outside of the faith. You're not fully in line with Christ, and you're not both walking on that same path towards God. So it's like, you can't really have a relationship if you guys are going in separate directions, because God is the glue and God is the way and God is that mutual endpoint for both of you guys. So if one person's going that way and one person's going that way, it's not going to work on that physical or that spiritual level. So in that sense, that's, you know, that's a standard, that's a preference that I cannot overlook, you know, within my dating life. You know, I have to always make sure that that's checked off, you know, at the end of the day, because I know that if I go into something and that is not aligned from that level, from that faith level, I'm just setting myself up for failure. And, you know, a lot of times people will say different things like, "Oh, you're being too rigid," or "You're being judgmental." It has nothing to do with being judgmental. That's just standing by your beliefs and standing by, you know, what is most efficient for your life. You know, that's the end of the day, that's what you're supposed to do. I didn't choose you to accept me or to not accept me. That's just my life and how I perceive the world. And if you don't fall in line with that, that's not your fault. It's not a bad thing, so to speak. It's just the way that I live my life. So a lot of times you'll hear, people saying, oh, you should like people as they are. You shouldn't, look at those types of things and use those. Love is love. And but that's not true. That's not true. And that's why we see the divorce rate so high. That's why we see all these things happening, within all these failed marriages, is because people think that that's it, but they don't weigh and measure that, the spirit, is deeper than everything. Everything goes underneath, to come to the top. So we have to always look at those standards before, weigh and measure before we even get into these deep situations, and then we don't have a chance to come out, and now we're just compromising and saying, okay, that's it, I'm already stuck in here, so I might as well just let it go and just let it ride. No, you could have took care of it in the beginning. It's about being proactive, not reactive. I think generally speaking, people have to stop getting so overly, emotional and feeling like they're bad people when they don't, hit somebody's preference, when they don't fall in somebody's preference. If you get, rejected because of that, it's not a bad thing. You're not a bad person. It just means that they, have a different ambition, for whatever else or someone else. It's okay. You have yours, they have theirs. We have to be able to respect that and honor those opinions. At the end of the day, there's somebody out there for you. But, don't get so stuck on, oh, that person doesn't like me because I do this. Or that person, no, it's not about that. It's about each person, finding their niche and finding what complements their spirit. Maybe one last personal example. Me personally, I've never dated, just for fun. Even when I was, started dating when I was like 23 or whatever it was, when I started getting, into that world. I always was dating for marriage. So I always look at it from a marriage perspective. Is this somebody that I can bring home to my family? Is this somebody that could be a mother to my kids? And you look at different things within a person and you say, okay, in the future, what does that look like? What they're doing right now, how does that translate into the future? You know what I'm saying? So that's how I was always ahead of my time, humbly speaking. When it came to dating, I was always looking at it, from that perspective. My ambition would be to bring a woman home that can, speak, as a woman should. In my opinion, this is my opinion, I'm not judging anybody, but speak as a woman should and, bring her home to mom and dad and see who she really is and not have all this profanity and that type of thing. And to raise my kids, to have a mom that show them, the right way to do things, business-wise, somebody that can manage her money and, is not going out, turning up at the club and getting drunk and smoking. And, I'm trying to raise, some D1 athletes, some intellectuals, some business owners, and everything physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, all those things got to align. And that's what I think about, what I'm saying? I'm deep into that stuff. I'm not just looking at, some girl because she looked good and I just want to go, put her in the bed. That's never been me. I'm always about the future. I'm trying to create a legacy, with my last name. So, that's just the way I think. Anybody else can have theirs, to each his own, but that's just how I see the world. And, take whatever you want from that, but that's what I was talking about when people have what they can accept with their standards and their preferences and what their red flags are. Everybody got their own stuff, but it doesn't mean that the person that's not on the receiving end is a bad person, or just because you don't fit those things because you're a bad person. It's not judgment. It's just the way that person sees the world and how they want to be. That's it. Even for a lot of my young men that I mentor, I tell them just start a little checklist. It's okay. It's not a bad thing to have things that you want in life, to have things that you see yourself pursuing in the future, manifest those things, put it into a vision, write those things down, 3 or 4 things, this is what I want in a woman. I want a wife that does this. I want, ain't nothing wrong with that, bro. See, that's a problem. A lot of us think that that's a bad thing to manifest, to try to plant those seeds. It's not bad, it's a great thing. We should all have those things, and it's okay. So, and you'll notice, even though your dating pool will be a lot smaller, it'll be so much more quality, within it. Even though those few whatever that might hit those few check marks, it's quality. it's quality. So now you're not wasting your time. You know, now you're not just getting to these wasteless relationships, taking all these dates and wasting this money and doing all this stuff when you know it's not going to work out at the end of the day. You know, you start from a first down. You know, start moving the ball already. You know, don't just be stagnant. Start moving the ball right now. So I'll just say that's it.